Deprogram Enlightener. Deprogram Enlightener.
Tazadaq, just an aggrieved man. I just want to clear some things up and, you know, give you some more vital information. You know, just wanted to say, you know, I attend the Hebrew Israelite Summit. Everything looked beautiful to see Israel come together like that. I give shaloms to the mighty Hebrew. Had a chance to build with the Ark, and his right hand man, Yeshaya. I give shaloms to that brother as well. Sorry, the mic wasn't actually turned up. The mic was turned all the way down, but, you know, we'll get together sometime in the future. A mighty Hebrew. Special shout out to the mighty Hebrew, Mighty Hebrew University. And, you know, the Kahan Hashah, Daniela, you know, all of the brothers out there, not cutting anyone short or anything. The brother Basar, you know, get with me. You know, I'm willing to go on that radio show if you are. But I'm here to talk to the people. And as you know, this is my call in my head. Like, you know, we all have, like, a special ability to do something very unique if we pursue it the way that we should actually pursue it. But some of you, you are actually afraid of being an entrepreneur, and you're accustomed to being, like, a consumer. So you're non-productive, and you're accustomed to being, you're accustomed to actually being told to do everything. So you become like robotic, and your mind is actually in a substandard condition. So most of you will never get this. Many of you say, "Oh, what's up with Tazadaq? He's a sovereign." Well, sovereign just simply means authority. I am not a sovereign citizen. I am sovereign. I am the authority, because from what I read in the scriptures, like, the Heavenly Father gave man power over all on the earth, all things, all creatures. So that means government in its public service capacity is subservient to I, man. That means the black robe is the subservient to I, man. That means the district attorney is subservient to I, man. Man has the authority over all because man in his proper capacity is sovereign. But when you go into these colorful courts, you go in afraid and you are therefore intimidated. So they get jurisdiction over you. You ignorantly, you know, not to insult anyone, but you ignorantly grant them jurisdiction. But how have they been capable of getting away with this fraud for so long? Because point one, and by the way, if you like this video, like it and share this video with as many people. If you want the truth to get out, then you need to actually help spread this truth with as many people as possible, because the more people that actually become educated on this and really truly understand law versus color of law or maritime admiralty law, which is a military tribune, then the more affected this will be. And don't say that this don't work. Just say you made some mistakes when you attempted to apply it. So this is not legal advice. I do not offer legal advice. What I'm offering you is law. Law that comes from the ecclesiastical law and law that comes from the Torah. That's what this system of law is built on. If you truly understand Torah, the ecclesiastical laws, then you will understand this man's systems of law, and you will know how to effectively deal with it as a man. Now, the supreme law of this land is supposed to be the Constitution, but that's only correct if you are capable of holding them to their oaths of office. So the first thing that you need to establish prior to going in any of these courts is which type of court it is that you're actually entering. Is it civil or is it criminal? If he said it's civil, then there has to be some sort of breach of contract. Is that correct? If it's criminal, then is it criminal under the common law, which reflect back to the Constitution of the Republic? Or is it criminal based on maritime admiralty, which is a military tribune? And the latter is the truth, but they're not going to tell you that. So the first thing you need to be capable of is intelligent enough to determine the court that you're in and articulate yourself properly. Don't go into their caliber courts thinking that you're speaking their language because you're speaking English and they seem to be speaking English. They're not speaking English. The black robe don't speak English. He's not speaking in that court. You're operating under presumption and assumption. So how have they been capable of getting away with this fraud for so long and managed to keep this secret maritime admiralty jurisdiction, which is actually a military tribune, it's because we're at war, that has come to the land from the sea. This is merchant law that has come to the land from the sea. And the answer is because the attorneys, the lawyers, are also control, they also control the fourth estate and institutions of religion and learning. Your schools are controlled by it. Your religious institutions are controlled by it. The news media, the mainstream media, aids and abets these esquires by suppressing the truth and perpetrating their lies. And some of you, you're so afraid when you go into the courts, some of you can't even speak. And you wonder why you can't win. And some of you are afraid to go in the damn courts. You get in the courts and you start calling me. How you calling me when you're supposed to be in court? See, it's all a form of mass mind control by way of subliminal perception, subliminal suggestion. They indoctrinate fear in you through their media. So the people are constantly fed a stream of propaganda through the network news, the mainstream media, the newspapers, the public school or food system, the colleges, the universities, and all lawyers, all of their corporations, these churches, are controlled by lawyers. The corporations that the people work for aid and abet the lawyers by actually perpetrating the false truth in the corporation policies. Now, you know, disrespect, I don't want to disrespect any Israelite groups, but you got IUIC saying, you know, sovereignty can't save you. That's because they don't know anything about this. And if you're for this system of law, if you have a 501c3 grant, then you can't be totally against the system. If this makes any sense to you, watch this, watch this. Either you're all right or you're not right at all. Either you're all right or you're not right at all. Because the Hamashiach said if you're lukewarm, you're going to be spirit out of the mouth. So you can't placate, or you shouldn't, because a lot of you do, placate on our people's emotions, and you get them caught up into your philosophies of Christianity that you're putting a title on it, Israelite, but you're doing everything that modern Christians do. And when I say Christianity, I don't mean the ancient Christians. So the subliminal message transmitted, or the lies that this de facto, or America, is a free country and slavery is abolished, that's a damn lie. And any of you that's actually been caught up into the system, you know that slavery is not abolished. Slavery is not abolished in America. America is the great land of opportunity, so they say. There is a separation of church and state, So they say. And the good Americans, especially good Christians, should submit to the government. And that is patriotic. A patriotic Christian thing to do. This is what they tell you. This is the propaganda that they feed you. So these themes never seem to cease. You hear it all of the time. On Hillary Clinton's side, so-called Democrat, and on Donald Trump's side, so-called Republican. It never ceases. They are constantly bombarded, and ingrained into the psyche of the masses of the people. And remember this, Hitler recognized in his work, in one of his work, that if you told a lie and repeated it and reinforced it often enough, the people would begin to accept the lie as the truth. So when I bring you right knowledge, when I bring you truth, you reject that because you've actually accepted the lie. Now I'm going to ask you, what is your status? Who are you? Where do you live? What is your country? Are you a new United States citizen? If you believe that you are, I will highly suggest that you email me right now at creditors.debtorscontracts@yahoo.com and say, Tazadaq, I need to become a secured party creditor. I'm tired of being a servant or a slave or a straw man or a corporate fiction. Or visit the website, www.creditors.debtorscontractsandcommerce.org. Click on the link for status correction and just follow the instructions. Or you can visit the other website, thelawsheepofisrael.org, and go to the link for status correction and say, Tazadaq, I'm tired of being a slave. Can you guide me through the process of correcting my status? And someone would actually be in contact with you as promptly as possible. But don't message me if you're not serious about this. I don't have time to answer your personal questions if you do not comprehend what this is. I got over 600 videos on my channel, Deprogramed Enlightener. Go there and watch the videos. I have another channel, The Undaunted National, because you have to learn to be undaunted. You have to get over that fear. To assert one's right is to do so confidently and without fear. So there's also the newer channel, the Universal Indigenous TV 7. Subscribe to all of those channels. And by the way, if you haven't ordered my book, The Infliction of Commerce, I suggest that you order that book because that book gives you a wealth of knowledge. 101 pages, a wealth of knowledge within that book. And anyone that's read it can assert to that. And also, my other book, The Hebrew Israelites versus Edom and Khazaria, will be a classic. So get that book as well. And you can get them both on Amazon.com, or you could go to those websites that I named and order either book. I prefer that you go to the website because Amazon doesn't get a cut out of it. But brothers and sisters, back to this. The bigger and more outrageous the lie is, the better it seems to be. Now, after a period of time, when the lie is actually sufficiently programmed into the sights of the national conscience and is accepted as the truth, the human mind does a remarkable thing. If the truth is then presented, like I bring you the truth, indisputable, irrefutable truth. But when that truth is presented, it is often rejected as a lie because you are programmed. So people say, why is Tazadaq walking around calling himself the Deprogrammed Enlightener? That's not me. That is the name of the channel. Because when you come to this channel, and if you watch the videos repetitively, as instructed, then you will be deprogrammed and enlightened with truth, with right knowledge, by Hashem Hamashiach Yahweh Shah. So, the truth will no longer be rejected. So, the psycho babyless who recognize this phenomenon and actually describes it as cognitive dissonance. So, the cognitive people is actually being compared to a programming of a computer. If the program lies and the force information into the computer, it will spew out lies and force information, or just lock up and completely cease to function. So junk goes in and junk comes out. So these cognitive dissonance is powerful and difficult to overcome. So many of you have struggled for years to overcome the false information that they have fed you. Now, another method very successful used by lawyers to keep their secrets under the cover of darkness is the age-old strategy of sending their minors, or their minions, should I say, to infiltrate, divide, and conquer our organizations, our people, and bending them from being together to resist the present tyranny of this injustice system. So, Tazadaq, I myself, have personally witnessed the effectiveness of this strategy. So, the minions of these esquires are actually sent to infiltrate our organizations. You must bear me witness. And they are actually intelligent, they're skillful, and they're highly trained in the art of deception and betrayal. They are people of likable personalities. They pick someone that you could actually like, who are able to actually gain trust and induce people into offending some maritime penal regulation and send them to prison. So the most active or successful patriots, as some refer to it, are the ones on top of the list to be targeted. So if you have an idea to uplift your people or to help your people escape from this mental bondage, you're at top of the list because you are a patriot for your people. See, they must be beaten into submission or neutralized, sometimes with extreme prejudice. Witness the fate of Marcus Garvey, of Malcolm X, of Martin Luther King, of the many, many leaders that try to raise up and they send someone in to infiltrate, to bring them down. See, some of these infiltrators are undoubtedly honest people that have run a foul of a maritime penalty. They broke the law in some way, and then what the de facto does, or these constables on patrol, they say, well, if you don't do this, or if you don't infiltrate Tazadaq's movement, we're going to give you X amount of years. If you don't bring the mighty Hebrew down, we're going to give you X amount of years. If you don't bring those Israelites down, we're going to give you X amount of years. So they cop a plea. See, these are agents. Agents of lawyers who travel our inner circles, holding, while we're holding, you know, summits or seminars and so on and so forth, and they try to bring something against us to bring us down. But the dawn is near. The sun, Hamashiach, Yahweh Shah, is rising. The path traveled by those seeking the truth of the fraud has been a long and arduous journey. So it passes through a jungle growing over the hollow remnants of many small businesses and the ruins of the family, the forms, the shells of homes once occupied by our people and close-knit families, and passes by the dead bodies of our ancestors and forefathers that fought for our rights that's now desecrated by a deranged youth, a perverted, deranged youth raised by unclean people. So the path to truth has actually been filled with stumbling blocks, seemingly insurmountable, and many folks lead to false trails. Many who have actually started down the path found the journey to be too difficult, and so difficult that they have turned back. Some of you started out with this, oh, I can't do this, it's just too much to learn, because you quit it. Quitting should never be an option. And others were more determined and are stronger characters have actually perished along the way. So a great debt is owed to those who have actually been blazed on the trail and lost their lives. Now, this video, brothers and sisters, is not the work of any one man. This is not the work of Tazadaq. It is an accumulated work of many, of our ancestors, of our forefathers. It is the accumulation of many pieces of giant puzzles that have helped assemble my mind with divine intervention. So, me, the author, sincerely believes that the timing of this revelation of Freud is key to the timetable of the creator, Yahweh. And his plan for the destiny of mankind and the universe has actually existed from the beginning, and the plan is actually nearing its final stages of execution. So all of you that's not in this truth, what are you waiting for? But as the end unfolds, you need to know how to survive in this man's system of a law. So the Most High has raised up brothers like myself, the mighty Hebrew, Hushaw, Daniela, and the many, 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 many other brothers out there. So the lawyers are soon to suffer the woes described in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 23. And the secular judges or black robes or magistrates are soon to be assured that most of their lives, they will live in fear of their own judgment before the supreme judge, Yahweh. Because they're responsible for their own actions, as observed by one of the jurors in the case of Robin versus Hardaway, 1 Jefferson 109. So let me talk briefly about the Sixth Amendment, and then I'm going to bring this to an end because I'm traveling down the highway. So the key, brothers and sisters, to the fraud hinge on comprehending the Sixth Article of Amendment of the Constitution of the United States Republic. And if I concur correctly, the discussion begins with the text of the Sixth Amendment as follows. In all criminal prosecutions, the accused shall enjoy the right to a speedy public trial by an impartial jury. Point blank, period. If you have criminal charges against you, you are entitled to a trial by jury. Point blank, period. Point blank, period. Of the state and district wherein the crime shall have been committed, which the district shall have previously ascertained by law, and to be informed of the nature and the cause of the accusation, to be confronted with the witness against him, to have compulsory process for obtaining the witness in his favor, and to have assistance of counsel for his defense. And I emphasize assistance of counsel for his defense. So the Supreme Court has held that there are no common law offenses against the United States, only those acts which Congress has actually forbidden with penalties for disobedience of its command and crimes. United States versus Hudson and Goodwin, 11 U.S., 7th Circuit. So, actions to recover penalties imposed by the act of Congress generally, but not invulnerable, have been held not to be criminal prosecutions. Competent proceedings, which were at one time not considered to be criminal prosecutions, are no longer within the category. So, what is the nature of the accusation? That's the question. So, if common law crimes against the United States does not exist, I'll say that again. You to hear me well. If common law crimes against the United States does not exist, what kind of crime does exist against the United States? Well, Article 3, Section 2 provides four different jurisdictions: law, equity, admiralty, and maritime. So by process of elimination, we could automatically rule out law by virtue of the above Supreme Court holding. So equity is defined as justice administered according to fairness, as contrast with strictly formulated rules of common law. So the term equity denotes the spirit and habit of fairness, justice, and right dealings, which would actually regulate the intercourse of men with men. See Black Law 6. So equity deals with fictions like corporations, since it is common knowledge that law and equity have been combined and virtually indistinguishable from each other, that anyone who has witnessed criminal proceedings in court easily recognize that these criminals are quasi-criminal accusations are most unusually contrary to the spirit and habit of fairness and justice and right dealings of men with men. Therefore, the cause of action cannot be in equity. Do you understand? So if we move on to admiralty is actually defined in Bouvier's 1856 edition as the name of jurisdiction which takes cognizance of suits or actions which arise in consequences of acts done upon or relating to the sea, or, in other words, of all transactions and proceedings relative to commerce and navigation and damages or injuries upon the sea. This is maritime. Bouvier's 1856 edition defines maritime cause as those arising from maritime contracts, whether made at sea or on the land, that is, such as relate to the commerce, business, or navigation of the sea, as charter parties, marine loans, and so on and so forth. So, in general, the courts of admiralty have a concurrent jurisdiction with the courts of all maritime cases, and in some cases, they have exclusively jurisdiction, and I say that with emphasis. So, as long ago as 1851, the Supreme Court recognized that Congress has actually the power to extend the jurisdiction of admiralty in maritime cases to the land under the Commerce Clause and deprive the people of the right of a trial by jury. And knowing thus, what I'm about to tell you, holden by the higher court, pretty much says it all. So this is, before I tell you this, this is why I highly suggest you get my book, The Infliction of Commerce. Go to Amazon right now and Google, type in The Infliction of Commerce by Tazadaq Shah. Order the book. You can get the book or you can get it on Kindle. Get it now because it will get your mind right. So, this power of admiralty jurisdiction is an extension upon the land as upon the water. So the Constitution makes no distinction in that respect. And if the admiralty jurisdiction in matters of contract and torts, which the courts of the United States may lawfully exercise on the high seas, can be extended to the lakes under the power of regulated commerce, see, it's all about commerce, 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 it can be with the same preparatory, or it could be the same upon the land and the same upon the sea, the same type of construction be extended to the contracts and torts on land when the commerce is between different states. So it may actually embrace the vehicles and the persons engaged in carrying it on. So it would be in the power of Congress to confer admiralty jurisdiction upon its court over the cars engaged in transporting passengers or merchandise from one state to another, and over the persons engaged in conducting themselves, and deny to the parties of the trial by jury. Now, the judicial power in cases of admiralty and maritime jurisdiction has never been supposed to extend to contracts made on land and to be executed on the land. But if the power of regulating commerce can be an extended admiralty jurisdiction beyond its heretofore known and admitted limits, may be created on water under that authority. So the same reasons would actually justify the same exercise of powers on the land. So, you know, the very next year in 1852, the Supreme Court actually warned that admiralty or maritime threat to liberty was actually encroaching on the land and actually morphing itself on a air-breathing creature, just as a harmless tadpole transforms itself from a frog, or should I say transform itself into a frog, selachid, or a really ugly toad. So, brothers and sisters, next to revenue, when I talk that, you know they're talking taxes itself, the late extensions of the American courts of admiralty seems to be forming by degrees into systems that is actually overturning the Constitution and to deprive us of our best inheritance, the laws of the land. The people are actually being deprived of the law. So it would be thought in England a dangerous innovation if the trial of any matter on the land was given to the admiralty jurisdiction. So my question, has Congress expanded this admiralty and maritime jurisdiction? And the answer is defined, and the answer is actually, emphatically, yes. So one only needs to examine the codification at Title 18 of the United States Code, Section 7. So Title 18, Crimes and Criminal Procedures, Part 1, Crimes, Chapter 1, General Provisions, Section 7. And I'm going to read that for you. And I'm going to bring this to an end. So the term special maritime and territory jurisdiction of the United States is used in this title includes the high seas, any other waters within the admiralty and maritime jurisdiction of the United States and out of the jurisdiction of the particular state, and any vessel belonging in whole or part to the United States or any citizen thereof, or, and I emphasize that section, or to any corporation created by or under the laws of the United States or of any state, territory, district, or possession thereof, when such vessels is within the admiralty of maritime jurisdiction of the United States and out of the jurisdiction of any particular state. Any vessel registered, that means your child. Any vessel registered, that means your child. That means you. Licensed, that means all you of your hair salons and so on and so forth. That means all you that's getting license and registrations. Or enrolled under the laws of the United States, being on a voyage under the waters of any of the Great Lakes or any of the waters connecting them, or upon the St. Lawrence River, where the same constitutes the international boundaries lines, any lands, Slovakia, reserved or acquired from the use of the United States and under the exclusive and concurrent jurisdiction thereof, or any place purchased or otherwise acquired by the United States by consent of the legislature of the state in which the same shall be for the erection of fort, magazine, arsenal, dockyard, need for building, and so on and so forth. So brothers and sisters, if any of this applies to you, if you set yourself up as any of this by registration, by way of a contract, because Article 1, Section 10, Clause 1 of the Constitution states no state can pass any law impair the obligation of contracts, then you are a party. Then you are a party. Then this affects you. Then this applies to you. So, you are victims. You're victims, and what many of these victims accused of maritime crimes do not realize is that admiralty and maritime jurisdictions were merged with the law and equity jurisdiction in 1966. And if you doubt it, see the Federal Reserve Rules of Civil Procedures. Note to supplementary rules for certain admiralty and maritime claims. Don't believe me? Go and check it out for yourself. In fact, I always tell you to go and check it out for yourself. Don't believe me? Because after your research, you're going to find out that I'm telling you the truth. So all four cases, or all four causes of actions, are actually natures of the cause, which were once separate and distinct, are now rolled into one set of rules and indistinguishable from one another in this modernized, colorable court system. So, Federal Rules of Civil Procedures, Rule 1 provides that the rules govern the procedure of the United States District Court in all suits of a civil nature, whether cognizable as cause at law or in equity or in admiralty, with the exception stated in Rule 81. Rule 2 provides that there shall be one form of action to be known as the civil action, FRCP. Rule 9H provides that, in part, if the claim proposes, whether so identified or not, the RFCP rule, 38E, provides that the rules shall not be construed to create a right to a trial by jury of the issue and admiralty or maritime claims within the meaning of Rule 9H. So, brothers and sisters, well, now, aren't these rules revealing? Maybe this explains why the black rule can amend or reverse a jury verdict or even jail the jurors for contempt if they do not do what the judge tells them to do. So, it has happened. So the jury is just there for a window dressing to make the sheep think that there is a trial by jury. The jury is actually being tampered with for educational purposes. They're afraid. So law, equity, admiralty, and maritimes, the once separated and distinct jurisdictions, are now neatly rolled together in one set of rules, tried in the same courtrooms with the same black robes on the same docket, and with nothing to distinguish the different jurisdictions one from another. So when you go in and you challenge jurisdiction, the judge is trying to make you sound like you're crazy. They've even actually suggested psych valuations. And you getting mad with me for teaching the people this? I'm trying to save your mind and save your souls. I'm trying to give you right knowledge and telling you the truth. So if the criminal accusation that plagues the people today are not in the jurisdiction of the common law or equity, they must be in admiralty or maritime jurisdiction. And though the admiralty and maritime jurisdiction are virtually indistinguishable, Bouvier's definition of maritime cause, as those arising from the maritime contract, whether made at sea or on land, fits the bill. Do you understand? Do you understand? So brothers and sisters, get your minds right. Get your minds right. You wonder, oh, what Tazadaq, he's always talking out law stuff. You need to wake up and start studying the law. You need to wake up and learn some law because you're going to get caught up. You usually always wait until you go into dishonor. You usually always wait until you're in a dishonorable position, and then you come for help, and then it's too late. So watch this video several times so that you can get this information embedded into your subconscious. Share this video with as many people as you possibly can. And if you need some personal coaching, feel free to email me at creditorsdebtorscontracts@yahoo.com. Do not email me stating that you want to become a secured party creditor. And then, once I respond, you're telling me, oh, well, yeah, weeks from now, give me a couple weeks, give me a month, give me a few months. Do not reach out unless you are clear on what you want to do. I'm not here to persuade anyone. I'm only here to give you the truth. But if your mind has been discombobulated and controlled like the mass mind, then you first have to be deprogrammed. So when you message me, it's time to be enlightened. You watch the videos, you're going to be deprogrammed. Then, in the same simultaneously process, you're going to be getting enlightenment. So you're deprogrammed and you're enlightened. So if you haven't subscribed to the channel, subscribe to the channel. Subscribe to the other channel, Undaunted National, because you have to be undaunted. You have to be able to assert your rights without fear. He that does not assert his rights has none. If you are fearful, you have no rights. If you said that this don't work, I know it's something that you're doing wrong. That only means that there's something that you've done wrong, because it does work. I've proven it many times. I've actually guided others through the process of this working. And unless you wake up, you're going to be laid down by a de facto that makes you, that has you under the delusion or illusion that your best interest is in mine. Your best interest is not in mine, folks. So wake up. You could actually get down or lay down. Either you get down with this program or they're going to lay you down. You're already a voluntary slave. Stop volunteering to be a slave. Stop volunteering to go to jail. Stop volunteering to pay taxes. Wake up. Get your minds right. Shalom, Yasha'Allah. Kwam Yasha'Allah. Tazadaq is out.
Deprogram Enlightener.